They might speak about their own company and promotions.
Good afternoon. Thanks for coming to this presentation. I'm going to talk about choosing the right partner in your PostgreSQL journey. So this is sort of a marketing talk, but I'm supposed to deliver it because our marketing guy didn't get his visa on time. So I'm stepping into his shoes. And that's why my title is director and not PostgreSQL consultant. I mean, those who know me as a PostgreSQL developer and consultant, right? But I'm playing the role of director here for the presentation, just to make it look a little glossier and, you know, better. So incidentally, we formed 2ndQuadrant India Private Limited a few months ago so that local customers could pay us in the local currency instead of paying in dollars and all. So I guess the talk was meant for an introduction to people who are new to PostgreSQL. So, you know, but I think everybody's attended Jim's talk, right? And there we have seen about the features and facets of PostgreSQL. Most importantly, it's a very liberal open source license, and anybody can do anything that they want with it, right? So. And here are some cool factoids about PostgreSQL. Because of its architecture and the way it's implemented, you can virtually have unlimited database size. A single table can grow up to 32 terabytes in size. And you have partitioning and inheritance. So that means that, obviously, a logical table could be much, much larger in size. A single row can grow up to 1.6 terabytes in size, and one field in that row can grow up to 1 GB in size. And you have unlimited rows per table, and so on and so forth. So in terms of features, PostgreSQL has been marching along very nicely, and as Jim also mentioned, you know, we've kept on adding a lot of new features into Postgres, and we've done that while by remaining SQL compliant, right? So there are a lot of proprietary databases who come up with their own variations in the SQL syntax or the usages, and that is called as in double quotes vendor lock-in, right? So they try to make it difficult for you to move or migrate from them to compliant databases. PostgreSQL is very, very standards compliant, and we don't deviate from the standards that much. It was developed in academia, so it is designed for extensibility. You can write your own user-defined indexes, your own user-defined types, and so on and so forth. So it is pretty extensible. It's a database which you can use for both OLTP and OLAP. Big data is pretty cool nowadays, and because of the features that PostgreSQL has inherently, you can use it for analytics as well. So there is no need to have a separate system for analytics and a separate system for OLTP. PostgreSQL and derivatives based on PostgreSQL will do the job pretty well. So, and as I mentioned, you know, that's why it's good for data warehousing and data mining, which forms the OLAP part. In terms of some Web 2.0 or big data features, we have had support for key value store since quite a long time. So, HStore is a key value store extension. We have very good support for XML and JSON, which is which are the most talked about Web 2.0 features now. You can do table sampling, which means that there is no need to look at the entire content of the table. You can just pick up a random sample of the contents of the table and derive your deductions from that. That is pretty useful for your analytics, where you don't need the exact value, but you are interested in a sufficient predictable, sufficient demonstration of what you're looking for. We also support broad range indexes, which is, block range indexes, which means that for a given set of blocks, you can track the minimum and the maximum value. And instead of indexing each row, you would just have an entry which says that, for example, page 1 to page 100, the maximum value for your key is 1,000, and the minimum value is 1, right? And in recent times, a lot of work has gone into supporting parallel queries in Postgres. So that continues to be improved upon. We also have the concept of foreign data wrappers, which allows you to connect to, let's say, an Oracle database or a MySQL database or even a flat file and query it using the SQL interface. So this feature is pretty useful for doing data aggregation across a varied set of heterogeneous data sources. PostgreSQL is used by a lot of big names. So, I mean, here's just a sampling of the companies that are using Postgres. Jim also mentioned about this. So. And it's personally, it's pretty cool for me because it happens to be my livelihood. I mean, I've been using PostgreSQL for 10 plus years now. And I've been part of startups based on Postgres and the derivatives. And we've done pretty well. So it has provided me a decent livelihood so far. And I hope it does keep on doing well so that I can continue to earn a decent livelihood, right? So so Jim has, basically covered a lot of these aspects as well. Just to summarize, it was born in academia in University of California, Berkeley. And Dr. Michael Stonebreaker was working in Ingress, and he started it after Ingress or post Ingress. That's why he called it Postgres, right? So because it was born in academia, it was a rethink, and a lot of emphasis was paid on extensibility and having user-defined objects being made seamlessly available in Postgres internally inside the database. There's no need to go through this. We already saw this today in the morning. But you can see that phase 4 has been really significant. There's been an increased adoption of PostgreSQL because we have targeted performance and scalability and HA and heterogeneous replication or stuff like that. And that has really caught the attention of a lot of companies, and that's really helped a lot in the increased adoption that we see of PostgreSQL nowadays. So in terms of the community, we have a hierarchy. There's the core team of 5 members. There are committers, there are contributors, major contributors and contributors. And this is where the second quadrant specific stuff starts. This being a sponsored talk, we wanted to highlight the contribution our company has made into open source PostgreSQL. So second quadrant has worked on a number of features and we have successfully included them in core. The most important features that we can highlight is point-in-time recovery, which really allowed disaster recovery way back in 8.0. Then having read-only queries happening on the hot standby, that stuff was added by us, second quadrant. We are actively working on multi-master replication. I also happen to be part of the multi-master BDR 3.0 initiative that's happening. Incidentally, this is the topic that I'll also talk about in my next presentation, which follows this presentation. So I hope to see some of you there. Excel is another strongly coupled multi-master solution, which we are also working on. And since we are working on replication multi-master, we have also contributed to logical replication in core in 10. In terms of contribution by second quadrant, as you saw in the previous slide, it's significant, and that is because we have the biggest collective of PostgreSQL contributors. We have one member of the core team out of the only out of only 5 in the world, and we have 17 major contributors. So names like Peter Eisenstrott, Pavan Deval C, the list just goes on, right? It's 17 major contributors, Peter Jalinek, Craig Ringer. These are all very well-known names in the community, and they work for 2nd Quadrant. And we're proud to say that, you know, we are the only company to support major features into all last 13 releases that have happened in Postgres. So we're pretty stoked about that. So, but, you know, you might be looking at our slides and then say, okay, what's so great about it, right? I mean, I don't care, you know. I'll tell you why you should care in the next slide. You as an end user should care because we are PostgreSQL experts, and we are the ones who will be actually providing the support for your queries at the back end, right? So you can be rest assured that the support that you get is top notch. Because we ourselves add that code, if there are bugs and issues, and we are experts in that field, we can definitely fix it in quick time. So that's why we are confident enough to blindly acknowledge and guarantee a 24-hour bug fix period, right? So that, I think, is also pretty significant. And not just that, we also follow the sun principle support, right? So we have support people spread across the globe, and we provide 24/7 support, and people in different time zones will be available to you because your system can go down at any time, anywhere, right? So you cannot have local people staying up in the night and trying to help you. So our team will be available 24/7 across different geographies and continents, and they'll help you out. These are our SLAs, you know, response within 15 minutes to your query, a workaround within 4 hours, and a bug fix within 24 hours, right? And we continue to get amazing feedback from our customers. We are like, our satisfaction rate is above 90%, which is unheard of in the industry. If you get 75% or above, we are supposed to be very good, but we continue to get 90% approvals in the ratings of satisfaction surveys. In terms of other offerings, we have remote DBA, where you can do monitoring and alerts that can happen real time. And this is pretty useful for people who just want to focus on their core business. If you are an e-commerce store and you are selling toys online, right? You want to focus on keeping that service online and selling it to more customers. You don't want to spend your time worrying about your database uptime, right? You don't want to spend worrying about performance issues of your database or HA of your database. So this remote DBA offering is pretty good for those environments where you just want to focus on your core work, and whether and you can just outsource the DBA activity of your database to us. And you can also, you know, do health checks and performance tuning, by which you can identify what are the actual bottlenecks in your system. So you can do it preemptively. So in the case, you know, if you're envisioning that there's going to be a huge growth, then you can plan capacity for that. Or if you are facing issues, then you can get a health checkup done. So we can tell you, you know, which are the pain points and which exact objects need maintenance or reshuffling or partitioning or something like that. So that's possible with us. And security is a big aspect threat nowadays. So you want to ensure that you are not keeping your ports open for access by anybody else. You are following standards. If you're dealing with PHI or PII, health information or identification information, then you need to ensure that it's properly containerized in a safe manner, right? Additionally, you might take backups, and those backups might be, you know, available easily to outsiders, and that is as the same as losing your main database. So security of backups is also pretty important, and logging and auditing is also plays an important part if you have to have compliance needs for your business. I mean, we can continue talking about stuff. Some more stuff that we work on is BDR. As I said, I'll talk about that next in the next talk. Logical replication using PG Logical is a one-way replication where you can have a provider and a subscriber subscribing to the changes from that provider. We also provide tools like Rep Manager, which can be used for high availability management. So it can help you set up your master and standby, and then and in case if the master goes down, then the Rep Manager will ensure that one of the standbys is promoted to become the new master, and you can provide failover scripts to it so that it takes care of your other requirements alongside. For example, you might want to failover a virtual IP to your promoted standby if that promotion succeeds. So those kind of scripts can also be provided to Rep Manager. Excel I talked about. Barman is a very popular backup tool. It is very good for disaster recovery, and it has a bunch of features which can be used. It also provides incremental backups so that your backup sizes are kept under control, and it allows options for fast backup and recovery. So we have seen an explosion in the popularity of this specific tool that we provide. And recently we are working on OmniDB, which is a web-based interface to administer your database. So that was a brief about what all we do. Just wanted to mention that we have a lounge area. It'll be in a Robusta room from 2 p.m. onwards today. We'll be, our team will be sitting there, and we would invite all of you to come there and meet us. Pavan Devilsi, Abhijit Menonsen, and myself, we will be sitting there. So if you have any specific queries around how do you participate better in the community, or if you have any Excel, BDR, Postgres related queries, or questions about how Postgres should be used on the cloud, we'll be happy to share our thoughts on it. Okay, so that was it. These are some details about our website. We keep on blogging about the stuff that we work on, and you know the cool things that we are working on. So this is a good way. The blog is a good way to keep tabs on us in terms of what work is happening and how things are going. Right? Or if you have any queries, you can send an email to info@2ndQuadrant.com. Okay, I guess that's it. If there are any questions, let me know.
I think. Cool. Thanks, Nikhil. Thanks for the
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you.